Yes. So today we are going to see about this informative workspace. Informative workspace means it is one of the environments so that everyone will be involving and having some words on the white paper or some discussion on that particular project so that everyone will be sharing their ideas and the works, how to do, what to do, to implement, what are the things are required. These all things they are putting on some whiteboard or some PPTs, and here it is going, simply we can say that it is providing some informative workspace environment for all the team members and the developers who are involving in that, right? So that with the help of whiteboard or PPTs, they will be doing the discussions and they will be putting their ideas and the requirements to work on the particular projects, right? So that is the informative workspace. And here we can see that big visible charts, right? Either they will be using some whiteboards, charts or PPTs or some paper, they will be gathering all the ideas and the informations, right? If they take the big visible charts, okay, so that it will be a good, right? So that the information and whatever they will be displaying, it can display to the everyone, right? Who can communicate, whoever are sitting room or particular room, they can easily see that particular things and can involve in that, right? So for display the information, right, for whatever the task we are going to be done, so that it will be easy and so that everyone can interact on that particular points, right? Either we can use some visible charts or some hand-drawn charts, right? Hand-drawn chart, we can process the improvement charts also, right? So these all things we can use to put all our information, right? So the charts takes the forms of has like diverse types of problems, and the team is going to be experience what the work has been done and what is the pending. So what are the things required to improve our projects, okay? These all things they are putting on the different charts, right? So with the help of this chart, so they will be communicating with each other and displaying to each other in a team, okay, and gathering all the points and the information, right? So simply this informative workspace is nothing but it is one kind of the environment everyone are involving in that, and whatever the work is there, they are discussing on that and what to do, what not to do, what are the things we have to include in this project. These all things they are going to be look after, right? So experience and freshers, everyone will be involving in that, so that with the help of this workspace they can get some ideas so that they can implement their ideas, okay? If experienced persons are there, means they have a lot of practices on that, right? So they can give some guidance. With the help of that guidance also we can include in our project, okay? So that we can reduce our time, right? We can reduce our time and can implement our projects, right? So that's why they will be using some informative workspace before starting a project or in middle of the project or end of the project. Here they will be keeping some meetings, and at that time they will be using this workspace environments so that they can start their discussion. Based upon their discussion, they are going to be concluding and including all the things in the projects which is running and which is going to close, and it is going to be released, okay? At that time they will be providing all the information. That all information will be useful for all the developers and who are working on that particular projects, right? So that is the informative workspace. So in this informative workspace, they are going to be improve some processes frequently, right? So unnecessary tests and unnecessary things are going to be included without any testing. Okay, they will be doing some gaming. Some people will be trying to improve the process. Okay, some people will be trying to improve the process with the help of like a gaming method. Okay, they will be improving the process and they will be adding all the things and involving the persons, right? So gaming occurs when people try to improve the process frequently, right? If we include the code correctly and that project is working perfectly, means everything is okay. If we are doing testing, okay, unknowingly, we don't know what to do and where to insert that code. Okay, we are doing some test, means here, if it is work perfectly, means then okay. Otherwise, we need some time to work on it, right? So some people may using like a gaming method also. Either we'll see what will happen if I include this code and if I include these all things, what will happen? I will see like that. They will be checking, right? And the results means here it consists of like a informative workspace map. Where exactly you can come and how far you have to go in your current plan. Okay, whatever the planning is there, okay, what you have done and what you people are working and processing, these all things you are going to be identifying, and at last you people are trying to solving the problems in that, right? So whenever we are working on some particular project, ma, first we are doing some plan, right? First, we are doing some plan. So, first, we are doing some plan. Based on that plan only, here all the developers and the users are going to be working, right? So once the plan is perfect, means everything will go perfectly, ma, right? Everything will go perfectly. Or if they won't follow according to the plan, means everything will create the disturbance, right? So we are having some projects, right? So before developing one project, okay, this is our project. It is related to some technologies. They have to develop an application, right? So at that time here, first the team or the members, they will be generating one plan, okay? At what time we have to complete our coding and developing, okay? At what time we have to release and at what time we have to test. These all things will be included in this plan, right? According to that schedule, here all of us have to be working, right? So whenever, means based upon that planning, they have to work and solve the problems, right? So if they are not following this plan properly, means definitely it will be consuming some time, okay? Time, okay? Within that time, we can't submit to the stakeholders, right? We can't release that product according to our schedule. Okay, in plan I have scheduled like on so and so date we have to release our project and we have to hand over to the customer, right? So if we won't follow properly the plan, then finally it will be a problematic to us, right? So everyone have to involve informative workspace, and exactly they have to know what is there and how the things are working according to the current plan, and team is in progressing well or having any difficulty. These all things they will be checking and fixing that problems and solving with each other and working on that particular projects, right? So contradictions, when we will face the problems, right? Contradictions. So if your team doesn't sit together, okay, and they are unable to share their thoughts and ideas, and they are not supporting for us, right? and probably won't be able to create an effective informative workspace. Okay, at that time we may face a problems, right? So everyone have to involve, everyone have to give some idea, either it is a positive or a negative. If it is a good, we can include it. If it is not, even though some experienced persons will be there, they will be giving some guidance so that we can do some modification, right? Until and unless we are not supporting to our team means, then we can't work on that particular process or particular projects, right? And alternatives, if your team doesn't sit together, then it should use some electronic tools supplemented with daily stand-up meetings, right? With daily stand-up meetings, either we can send some mails or some reports or some meetings we can schedule, right? Otherwise we can do like this also, right? So with this they can gather some information and can work on that particular areas, right? So informative workspace, either we can do a testing, if we know perfectly means we can include where to include, how to include. Okay, if we know exactly where to include this all code and information means we can, right? So we can work on that. So this is about the information workspace, right? So next, coming to the root cause analysis, right? So what is this root cause analysis? Okay, why we are going to this root cause analysis? And actually remember one thing, ma, what is retrospective means? It is a type where we are fixing a problems or bugs. It will be giving some methods, okay, to solve that problem, to fix that problem. Okay, it will be providing some templates or some information. Based upon that we can get our solutions from that right? So that is retrospective. And coming to this root cause analysis, right? So here root cause analysis means, in this root cause analysis simply we are going to be presenting the mistakes, okay, by fixing our processes, right? So mistakes, we are going to identifying the mistakes and we are classifying the approach, what's the problem has been raised, right? In depth we are going to be searching that problem. If we know, we are fixing itself there only, otherwise we will be searching the problem from top to bottom, right? And here, so that everyone in this, whenever we are fixing the root cause analysis, fixing any problem, at the time we have to involve each and everyone, right? Each and everyone, we have to take the help of them, we have to discuss about that particular problem so that we can fix that particular root, right? So it helps you to move away from blaming the team members and towards identifying and underlying flexibilities all, right? So that everyone is involving and discussing on that particular thing, it will be helpful. So to do this root cause analysis, here we will be using some retrospectives, ma, right? Retrospectives means here we can say that continuously we are improving our work habits with the help of that retrospectives. Here we are going to be improving our works and we are going to be working on that, right? And remember one thing, no process is perfect, okay? No process is perfect. Your team is unique and your situations, your encounters and whatever the changes you have done according to the time, everything will be a different, right? And you must continuously update your process, right, to match your changing situations according to the customer requirements, right? So this retrospectives is a great and cool for working, right? It will be providing some solution for all the root cause analysis, right? That's why we are using this retrospectives and the various types, whatever the three types involved in that retrospectives, okay, that methods also we are using here, right? Like iteration, releasing and surprise, okay? Whatever the methods are suited, that all things we are going to be using, right? So here in root cause analysis, simply we can say here we are going to be making a mistakes. We are trying to fix that our mistakes and bugs, and we are going to be working on that, right? So for example, take one scenario, means problem statement. Based upon that problem statement, here we are involving all our teammates and developers who have worked on that and who are experienced on that particular area. Everyone we are involving. And here we are going to be involving, if the person know exactly where is the error and where is the problem, means directly he will switch to the code and he will try to include that, right? If the inexperienced person is there for that particular scenario, means he will be doing some gaming, okay, some testing. He will be including at initial stage, he will be including and testing. It will be consuming a time, and there will be, there may be a chances of raising a bugs, and lot of mistakes can be done by all these things, right? So to avoid these all things, here we are going to be using like how to find and fix the root cause, right? Exactly, how to find and fix the root cause. So root cause analysis is a technique you can use for every problem, right? You encounter from the trivial to the significant in the project environment. You can even fix some problems just by improving your own workspace, right? If you are working on that areas particularly from a long time, means definitely you can understand, yes, where is the problem and what is the effect, right? So for example, whenever you people visit to the doctors, at that time if an experienced doctor is there, by seeing our nerves only, he can identify what are the things going on. Right, some persons will, there are some inexperienced doctors, means like in depth, they can't identify that all things, right? They need some reports, these all things they will be doing from starting from top to bottom, they will be observing, then they will be trying to fix that exact problem, what is the problem in that a person, okay, right? Like that only, here in our project also, if we are involving the experienced person, and inexperienced person means here the difference between that we can see easily, right? So fixing the root cause. So how to fix and fix the root cause? So fix the root causes, okay, requires gather the people and cooperate with them and involve in them, okay, gather the team members. Has any problem? Pooja, Elfo, Pooja. Elfo, Pooja, can you off your mic? Elfo, Pooja. Pooja, Elfo, it's in recording, ma. So here fixing the root causes, and we are going to be involving the people's team members, and we are sharing the thoughts and helping the people to solve the problems, right? If this root cause is outside the team control, okay, if unable to identify that problem so that we can solve that problem, that problem may become difficult and it is impossible, right? If no one don't know about that particular problem solution at that time, here we are going to be taking some like offshores or third party helps also, and we are going to be including, right? So when not to fix the root cause, right? When not to fix the root cause means, first, where you going to be start or applying your root cause analysis? First, you have to find many problems. Okay, first you have to find a problem and where to fix. Okay, where not to fix, these all things. Once we identify the problem, yes, we can do this solution. We can add this solution, or we can fix these problems in that. We can easily identify, right, and can address simultaneously. Okay, within few time only, okay, it should not take some long time, okay, whenever we are fixing a bug or finding any root, means we have to find within time, right, and we have to apply some root cause analysis, okay, you have to ask or use whether that problem is common or not, okay, and common or not, like that. So that you will be discussing. If it is a common, means they will be rectifying, and it consumes a time very less, right? So whenever not to fix the root cause, means when you first start applying the root cause analysis, you will find many more problems than you can address, right? So don't do the experiments on that. If problems has been raised, means try to involve your team members, okay? If they have a solution, if they have faced that problem solution before only, then it will become very easy, right? And next, results. When the root cause analysis is providing some reactions, so that every team value is fixing some problems rather than placing a blame on each other, right? So there is no blame game, right? If you know, work it. Otherwise, don't blame your team members or whoever has been work, right? However, we are the human beings, ma. What we will be doing if anything happened to us, or if any problem has been created, what we are saying simply, anta vala vallane, anta vila vallane, right? Like that we will be saying. But we are not going to be pointing directly for us, right? You people only take the example. Whenever you people are writing some exams, external exams, if paper comes the tough or either it is a tough or easy, we don't. What you people will be doing, you people will be blaming to that particular who has prepared that question paper, that person. Yes, that fellow has been prepared tough question, but you people are not pointing yourself that we have not prepared perfectly, okay? You people never accept that, but you will be trying to blame the others. Either the faculty has been not explained properly, they have not given these all things, that's why we have not given these all. These all things you will be doing, right? So like that. So don't blame that. So blaming games will be there in there, right? Whenever the problem or any situation has been happened critically, we are trying to push that all things on the other person so that we can should be at safe side. Okay, like that you people will be doing, right? I'm right or not? Yes. Next, contradictions. So if a root cause is a beyond your control, work and someone, okay, such as the project manager who are unable to control that, right, who has experience coordinating with the other groups, in the meanwhile, solve that intermediate problem, focus on is in your control, right? So whatever the things we can do, we can work on that, you can fix and work on that. Right, meanwhile, so that we can find that solution with the other, either offshore, either by a third party, we can involve them, right? Some alternatives will be there so that we can fix the root cause, which is in control of the team, okay? Which is control of the team. So this is about the root cause analysis, right? This is about the root cause analysis. Important topics, ma, these all are